In the today's class, we will take up the AC circuits containing pure resistor, capacitor, and inductor separately. Okay, what happens to the phase between current and voltage? What will be the phase difference between current and voltage in these
recording in progress?
In these circuits, we will consider in the today's class. Let us take the first case, AC circuit containing a pure resistance only. A resistor is connected to AC. And how does current and voltage are having the relation? We will see. Suppose an alternating voltage source is connected to an external resistor of resistance R with the alternating current flowing through it. The alternating voltage is represented by V is equal to V naught sine omega t. Okay. So AC voltage is represented by V equal to V naught into sine omega t. The sinusoidal voltage is applied. Here V naught is the peak value of voltage and omega t is the phase. So sine of the angle, that angle is called as phase of AC. V naught is the peak value of voltage. Okay, that is the maximum value of voltage. This voltage can be represented in complex number representation as V equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t. Okay, and here sine omega t is represented as e to the power j omega t. That is how you can represent it in complex number representation. Here you know that e to the power j omega t is nothing but cos omega t plus j sine omega t. You know that e to the power I theta is equal to cos theta plus I sine theta. And here in place of I, we have j, where j is the complex number. Omega t is the angle theta. Okay, so that e to the power j omega t is nothing but it is cos omega t plus j sine omega t. Okay, so basically this sine omega t is imaginary part of this complex number. Okay, so one part of the complex number is represented here. And here, the circuit considered is represented like this. An AC source of voltage V equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t is connected to the external resistance. The resistance of the resistor is R. Now we have to find out what is the expression for a current I. And here direction of current is not represented because it is AC. It is not having particular direction. It will change its direction every regular interval of time. So now we have to find out what is the current through the circuit. So simple Ohm's law will use. So according to Ohm's law, IR is equal to V or V equal to IR. Okay. So I is the instantaneous current through resistance R. Then according to Ohm's law, IR is equal to the applied voltage V, where V is V naught into e to the power j omega t. Therefore, current through the resistor is I is equal to V naught by R into e to the power j omega t. Okay, as it is, just I will rearrange. So current will be V naught by R into e to the power j omega t. And finally, you can write current I is equal to I naught into e to the power j omega t, where I naught is V naught by R, that is peak current or maximum current. Because V naught is maximum voltage. Maximum voltage by resistance is maximum current. Here I naught is peak value of current in the circuit. Therefore, you will get I is equal to I naught sine omega t. Okay, I is equal to I naught sine omega t. I can write the e to the power j omega t as sine omega t. Now look at the angle, phase angle. The above two equations show that the alternating current and voltage have the same phase, or phase difference between them is zero. What was the phase of the voltage? Phase of the voltage is e to the power j omega t. Omega t was the phase of the voltage. What is the phase of current here? Current is also having the same phase, omega t. So phase difference between the voltage and current is zero. Okay. Therefore, in case of the AC circuit containing the pure resistor, current and voltage are in phase. So that is very important point you can remember. The phase of current and voltage may be represented in the complex number representation using this diagram. So here voltage is represented by this vector, this arrow mark, V naught is the maximum value and it is having the phase omega t. So face is represented as angle made by the vector with respect to real axis, that is called as face. Omega t is the phase of voltage, and also we have observed that current is also having same phase, omega t. So current and voltage will be in phase, so they will appear along same direction. That is the meaning of the voltage and current are in phase. Then what is the effective resistance of the circuit, or it is also called as impedance of the circuit? That is given by R is equal to V by I. That is in accordance with Ohm's law. Or you can write it as V naught by I naught, or you can write V RMS by I RMS. So all are giving you the impedance of the circuit when a resistor is connected to external AC. This about resistance. So just you have to remember, when resistance is connected to AC, the voltage and current will be in phase, and the effective resistance will be V naught by I naught. Next, we'll take AC circuit containing pure inductance only. Let us take the circuit containing inductor. Suppose an inductor of inductance L is connected to AC supply, whose instantaneous voltage is represented by V is equal to V naught e to the power j omega t. This is the voltage of AC connected to the circuit, and here V naught is the peak value of voltage and omega t is the phase of voltage, and this is the circuit. Okay. This circuit consists of an AC source, and it is connected to the external inductor. Inductor is a coil, and whose self-inductance is equal to L. L is the self-inductance of this inductor. Then the voltage applied is V equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t. And here V naught is peak voltage, omega t is phase of voltage. That is angle made by the voltage vector with respect to the real axis in complex plane. Now we have to find out the current through the circuit by the same way as we have done in case of the resistor circuit. Here we know that this inductor undergo the electromagnetic induction. Because of that, it will produce some induced current in the circuit, and that induced current is directly proportional to rate of change of current in the circuit. Okay, let us take I is the instantaneous current in the circuit, that is at any time t, and let us take di by dt is the rate of change of current which is responsible for the induced EMF in the inductor. And it will oppose the increase in current, as we have seen in transient case, transient phenomena. This inductor will produce some induced voltage, and that is directly proportional to di by dt. So that is having the expression minus L into di by dt. That is actually equal to the induced voltage. Now apply KVL to this circuit. What you will get? You will get voltage of AC plus voltage produced by inductor, that must be equal to zero. That is V minus L into di by dt equal to zero, where L into di by dt represents the induced voltage in the inductor. Here the negative sign indicates that induced EMF is in the opposite direction to the applied AC. It is in opposite direction compared to the direction of AC at any time. Now we have to solve this expression to find the value of I. Okay, so that we have to do. This is the expression we have got corresponding to the inductor circuit, V minus L into di by dt equal to zero. So here V is voltage is V naught into e to the power j omega t minus L into di by dt equal to zero. Just I have substituted for V, that is voltage of AC, and remaining things are kept as it is. Our aim is to find out the expression for I. That's why we have to integrate this equation after doing the separation of variables. Okay. So the above equation is used to determine the current I in the circuit. First, you have to separate the variables, or I can write the expression as di by dt is equal to V naught e to the power j omega t divided by L, where L is the inductance of the inductor. So just a rearrangement. You take this to the other side, take L to the denominator here. So integrate it. with respect to current, with respect to time here. So separation of variable, you can do it easily. If you integrate it, you will get I is equal to V naught by L. It is constant. Peak voltage is constant. Inductance is constant. If you integrate with respect to time, you will get e to the power j omega t by j omega. Okay. So e to the power x is e to the power ax. If you integrate it, you will get e to the power ax divided by a. So e to the power j omega t divided by j omega. So finally, you can combine current will be equal to V naught by j omega L into e to the power j omega t. I will combine them. V naught by j omega L into e to the power j omega t. Remember, this exponential term is dimensionless. So this is current. According to the dimensional analysis, this V naught by j omega L must have the dimension of current. So this is having dimension of voltage. If this ratio is having the dimension of current, this denominator should be the dimension of resistance, because voltage by resistance gives you current. That's why this j omega L must be having the dimensions of resistance. And here we can write this as I naught into minus j. This can be written as V naught by omega L as omega, V naught by omega L as I naught, and this 1 by j can be written as minus j, because we know that j square is equal to minus 1. Therefore, j is equal to minus 1 by j, or 1 by j is equal to minus j. And here we call this V naught by omega L as peak current. I naught is given by V naught by omega L, and minus j is introduced here. So 1 by j is minus j. Minus j represents that current is having phase difference of pi by 2, because we know that minus j means it is minus pi by 2. So this equation shows that the current is lagging behind the voltage by pi by 2 due to the presence of minus j in the equation, because according to j operator method, minus j means it is minus pi by 2 phase difference. It is lagging behind the voltage by 90 degree. Okay. You can represent this in this phasor diagram as below. So voltage is having omega t, then current is lagging behind the voltage by 90 degree. Okay. So if voltage is directed along this vector, then current should be 90 degree behind the voltage. That is in case of pure inductor. Okay. Now I can represent this minus j as e to the power minus j into pi by 2. Okay. So just I will try to understand it in detail. So just you take this particular expression, you will get e to the power minus j into pi by 2. That can be rewritten as cos pi by 2 minus j sine pi by 2, because it is e to the power minus j theta. So that is equal to cos theta minus j sine theta. So cos pi by 2 minus j sine pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. Cos 90 is 0. Sin 90 is 1. You will get minus j. So therefore, minus j can be represented as e to the power minus j into pi by 2. Substitute in the above equation. Therefore, the current through the inductor that was obtained as I equal to minus j into I naught into e to the power j omega t. For minus j, you put this exponential minus j into pi by 2. Okay. Therefore, I will be equal to e to the power minus j into pi by 2 into I naught into e to the power j omega t. Combine these exponential terms, you will get I naught into e to the power j omega t minus j pi by 2. Combine them, you will get I is equal to I naught into e to the power j as a common factor into omega t minus pi by 2. Just you recall, what was the phase of voltage? Voltage was represented as V equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t. J omega t was the phase of voltage. What is the phase of current here? It is omega t minus pi by 2. That's why current is behind the voltage by pi by 2, minus pi by 2. Omega t is the phase of the voltage. Omega t minus pi by 2 is the phase of current. So it shows that in case of the circuit containing inductor, The phase of current is omega t minus pi by 2, so that current has a phase difference of pi by 2 with the voltage. Therefore, the inductor produces a phase difference of pi by 2 between alternating voltage and current, and is represented in this figure according to the phasor diagram. Okay, so according to phasor diagram, if this is the voltage having the phase omega t, then current should be omega t minus 90 degree, omega t minus 90 degree, minus pi by 2. So current should be represented along this direction. So therefore, in case of inductor, voltage is leading the current. Voltage is leading the current. It is in positive direction. Current is lagging behind the voltage by 90 degree, and there is a phase difference of 90 degree between them. Okay, that is in case of inductor. So finally, we can represent this I as V naught by j omega L into e to the power j omega t. That was obtained, and I will be minus j into I naught into e to the power j omega t. In this equation, I naught equal to V naught by omega L. Okay, so here I have represented V naught by omega L as I naught, and this is having the dimension of current. V naught is having the dimension of voltage. Therefore, this omega L must be dimension of resistance, because V by R gives you current I. V by resistance, voltage by resistance, gives you current. This omega L can be represented as 2 pi FL, where omega is the angular frequency of AC, L is the inductance of the inductor. Omega can be represented as 2 pi F, where F is the linear frequency of AC. And this omega L is called as inductive reactance of the inductor, which is basically the resistance offered by the inductor to the AC signal. And usually it is denoted by XL. Okay, X subscript L. X subscript L is inductive reactance. That is basically the resistance offered by the inductor to the flow of AC. So the expression for XL is given by omega L, or it can be represented as 2 pi FL, or it can be represented as V naught by I naught when an inductor is connected in the circuit. Okay. Remember, XL is equal to omega L. That is the resistance offered by the inductor. Here, XL depends on frequency. Just to observe, this XL depends on frequency of AC. It offers higher resistance for higher frequency AC. As frequency increases, this XL also increases. And for DC, frequency is zero, for which XL is going to be zero. Therefore, for DC, inductance behaves like a simple resistance R. It will not change, because the frequency of DC is fixed, it is zero. Therefore, XL is zero. Inductive reactance is zero. Therefore, inductor will not offer any resistance for the flow of DC. But for AC, it offers some resistance, and that resistance is given by omega L, where omega is the angular frequency, L is the inductance. Okay. Next, finally, we'll complete this one. AC circuit containing pure capacitor. Suppose we have a circuit, a AC circuit containing a capacitor of capacitance C. Voltage applied is V equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t. Okay. And current we have to find. And here V naught is peak voltage, peak value of AC voltage, and omega t is the phase of voltage. And also you have to find out what is the phase of current. Okay. Now you use a simple expression, that is instantaneous charge on the capacitor is basically given by Q is equal to C into V. So just I will introduce one more expression here. Basically, we have Q is equal to C into V. The charge on the capacitor is given by Q is equal to C into V. Okay, charge on the capacitor is given by Q is equal to C into V, that is capacitance into voltage. Therefore, charge on the capacitor Q is equal to C into V naught into e to the power j omega t. Substitute for V. This is the basic formula. charge of the capacitor is equal to C into V. We know that voltage across the capacitor is Q by C. Using that only we have obtained here. Okay, already you have covered in transient phenomena. Next, using that, you have to find out what is the current. So charge on the capacitor is known to us. Q is equal to C V naught into e to the power j omega t is the charge on the capacitor. You have to find the current. What is current? Current is rate of flow of charges. Therefore, corresponding to this charge, the alternating current flowing through the capacitor C at any instant of time is given by I is equal to dq by dt. Just you have to differentiate this equation. Okay. So this has to be dq by dt. So if you differentiate this one, you will get C is a constant, V naught is constant. You have to differentiate this with respect to time. So you have to differentiate e to the power j omega t with respect to time. Derivative of e to the power j omega t is e to the power j omega t into j omega. Okay. So this has to be dimension of current because e to the power j omega t is dimensionless. This j omega c into v naught should be having the dimension of current because left hand side is the current. Therefore, I can rewrite this as j into v naught by 1 by omega c into e to the power j omega t. And here this 1 by omega c should have dimensions of resistance because this is voltage by resistance that gives you current. And we have plus j here. Therefore, current is having the plus pi by 2 phase difference. Plus j means pi by 2, plus pi by 2 phase difference. Minus j means minus pi by 2 phase difference. Therefore, current is leading the voltage by 90 degree. Again, I can represent this j as e to the power plus j into pi by 2. Okay, that is given by cos of pi by 2 plus j into sine of pi by 2. So there is no j here. So I can represent this j as e to the power j into pi by 2 because e to the power j into pi by 2 is equal to j because it is cos pi by 2 plus j into sine pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0, sine pi by 2 is 1. So j can be represented as e to the power j into pi by 2. Combine them, you will get v naught by 1 by omega c into e to the power j into omega t plus pi by 2. Okay, e to the power j omega t into e to the power j pi by 2. Combine them, you will get e to the power j into omega t plus pi by 2. So you look at the phase of the current here. Phase of the voltage is omega t. Phase of the current is omega t plus pi by 2. And this 1 by omega c is called as the capacitive reactance. That is resistance offered by the capacitor for the flow of AC. Here 1 by omega c is represented as xc, that is called as capacitive reactance, which is the resistance offered by the capacitor for the flow of AC. Also, I can write this expression, this I naught, as V naught by xc, which is called as peak current. I can write this V naught by 1 by omega c as I naught, which is called as the peak AC current that can flow through the capacitor. So finally, the current through the capacitor is given by I is equal to I naught into e to the power j into omega t plus pi by 2. Okay, where I naught is V naught by 1 by omega c. Okay. And voltage was V equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t. Look at the phase difference. Phase of the voltage is omega t. Phase of the omega t plus pi by 2 is, phase of the current is omega t plus pi by 2. There is a phase difference of pi by 2 between voltage and current. It is clear that current leads the voltage by phase angle pi by 2, or current has a phase difference of pi by 2 with respect to voltage. So current is leading. So current will lead the voltage. And you can represent this, that current and voltage in case of capacitor circuit as this particular figure. If this is the voltage that is represented along this vector V naught, which is having the phase omega t. So voltage is having the omega t phase, that is angle made by this vector with respect to real axis. Then phase of the current must be omega t plus pi by 2. Omega t plus pi by 2, plus 90 degree. So current is leading here. Current is moving far away from the voltage. It is moving in front. So that is, it is leading the voltage by pi by 2, angle pi by 2. So phase difference between voltage and current is pi by 2. That is how we can represent this in phasor diagram. Finally, the capacitive reactance XC, it is equal to 1 by omega C. Here it is also depending on the frequency of AC signal. And here you can observe capacitor offers high reactance for lower frequency AC, and it is negligible reactance for high frequency AC, because omega C is, it is in the denominator. If you take higher frequency, then XC will be smaller. Higher value of omega means XC will be smaller. So capacitive reactance is smaller for high frequency AC. For a low frequency AC, XC will be more. Therefore, in case of AC circuit containing capacitor, the capacitor will offer higher resistance for low frequency AC, and it offers lower reactance for high frequency AC. That's why capacitor is basically used as filter to separate high frequency signal and low frequency signal, because it will allow the high frequency signal easily, whereas low frequency signal will be attenuated, that will be stopped by capacitor. That is one use of capacitor, and that can be understood by using this particular capacitive reactance. Finally, you can represent this XL and XC in phasor diagram using J operator method. So we will complete this one and let us stop there. We know that the inductive reactance XL can also be represented in terms of J operator method, and that is given by J omega L. You can recall, while deriving the expression for current in the inductor circuit, we have obtained XL is equal to J omega L, which introduces plus the pi by 2 phase difference between current and voltage. So plus J represents plus pi by 2. So this is moving forward with respect to the resistance. Okay. And in case of capacitor circuit, capacitive reactance XC is given by 1 by J omega C. 1 by J can be written as minus J. Minus J into 1 by omega C, which introduces minus pi by 2 phase difference between current and voltage. That's why if you compare this XL and XC with respect to real axis, XL will be on positive imaginary axis, plus J on positive imaginary axis. XC will be in the negative imaginary axis. It is having plus pi by 2 phase with respect to real axis. XC has minus pi by 2 phase with respect to real axis. Therefore, total phase difference between this XL and XC is pi by 2 minus of minus pi by 2. It is total pi. So 180 degree phase difference is observed in between these two inductor and capacitors. So that can be understood. If you represent impedance and reactance of the inductor and capacitor in vector form in a complex plane, that is in phasor diagram, it is clear that XL will lie on plus J axis, on the vertical axis. On the vertical axis, along positive direction, this XL will be observed. And XC will lie along minus J axis. It is on the negative imaginary axis, negative vertical axis. So XL like this, XC in the opposite direction. And resistance R is along real axis, because the resistance will not introduce any phase difference between voltage and current, because in case of resistor, current and voltage will be in phase. Therefore, resistance will lie along real axis. XL will lie along positive imaginary axis. XC will lie along negative imaginary axis. And that is how we can represent the inductive reactance and capacitive reactance using J operator method also. Okay. So we'll stop here. We'll continue in the